Hey love, so it's your girl April, and today's video is going to be a 360 lace wig by missby.com. This is their pre-plucked virgin Brazilian in 22 inches with a 150% density. There are combs in the front. As you guys see, I have a full bag of lace wig tape right here, like from back in the days, from 2010, and also I have the same glue from back in 2010, which is Aquabond. This is the top guard, and this is also the lace release. All of this that I'm showing you is from back in the days, from 2010. I've actually held on to it, along with that my favorite tape, super tape. So the reason why I'm showing you guys all this is because you're going to need a bobby pin, not bobby pin, but some tweezers, a scissors, some clips, and something to clean your foreheads, because we're going to get into how I used to do it back in the days. So as you guys see right here at the top left corner is me back in 2010 doing my lace wig application. It's the same way, same exact method. You know, you clean your forehead off with any debris and you put your wig cap on. Don't put it on all the way. I'm going to be applying the top guard to my hairline, or prior to my hairline, so that way when I do glue the wig cap down, it will guard against my skin. And you do want to allow that to dry for at least 1 to 2 minutes, and of course I did that already. And once you have allowed that to dry, you want to go ahead and pull your stocking cap down as far as it will go, and you want to get your glue. Now, back in the days, I did use Krylon, but today I'm going to be using my Aquabond glue. Kind of smells like Elmer's. And I'm going to take a makeup brush, and I'm going to apply that glue on the outer portion of my wig cap, right like before my hairline. So that way, the wig cap will stick. So you want to do that. It kind of you want it to dry tacky. So I'm just going to take that. I'm just going to smear it all over the front perimeter of my hair. Not on my hairline. Try not to get any of this on your hair or hairline. But just keep in mind that it does take a few minutes to dry. So I went ahead and used the blow dryer back in the days. I just walked around the house for like 5 minutes and allowed it to dry. So as you guys see right here, I am using my blow dryer just to get it tacky. And now once it is tacky, you do see the color kind of like disappear a little bit. I'm going to go ahead and cut away the extra ends of the stocking cap. Same method that I did back in the days, back in 2011, 2010, 2012. But you know, time evolves and you stop doing that. But I figured I would show you guys exactly where the stocking cap method did come from, so that way you guys are really aware of how it all started. So yes, you guys, back then this is exactly how we used to do our lace wigs. But I would take an extra measure and I would then go ahead and apply some tape to the cap, so or the ends of the cap, because listen, your girl really did like for her wigs to hold down tight, like super duper tight. So once you have your tape down, you just want to make sure that you have it smoothed down. I do like to clip the hairs back because I don't want it to get in the way of the tape or the glue. And I always feel like it's much easier to remove the paper from the two-sided tape with tweezers. That's the reason why I had the tweezers, because it just makes things a whole lot easier. Like I said, using the tape and the glue at the same time will make your wig sit so tight that, trust me when I tell you, it's not going nowhere. So as you guys see right here, I went ahead and pulled the hairline down. Now back then in 2010, when this video was shot, the original video, of course the hairlines weren't that great. We didn't tweeze them. We just kind of like styled them the best we could. We might have had a little bit of baby hairs, little wispies, but you know, it is what it is. We still did the same method as gluing it, taping it, and all that stuff. You know what I'm saying? It's the same exact method. Now I'm going to go ahead and take my comb, my rat tail comb, and I'm just going to press the hairs down into the wig and the lace, into the tape, into the gel, and the glue. I know some people do use the got to be glue, and I'll try that method next time go around, but for this video's sake, I wanted you guys to see how we did it back in the days when lace wigs was first, you know, popping on the scene, you know, shit popping. So if you're wondering where did the video actually come from, this older video, it did come from my very first YouTube channel, which was Just Muffin Is My Lovers, and that's where it all started from for me. But you know, time has evolved and I am on a new channel now. So this hair that I'm doing by Miss By is actually really, really pretty. And just to kind of like make it look a little bit more scalpish, I did use some of my pressed powder by Too Faced, as you guys see right here in the newer video. And I'm just going to brush that into the part. The wig is on so tight, okay, like super duper tight. Now it's time to just make it look a little bit more natural. So I'm going to take my scissors and cut a little bit of hairs into this unit. Nothing major because I don't want a lot of baby hairs. Less is more, or whatever the good saying is. You know what I'm saying? I don't want a lot of baby hairs. I don't like a lot of baby hairs. So even though you see me cutting enough of them, doesn't mean I'm going to be using them all. Now to style and lay down my edges on my baby hairs, I'm going to be using some Herbal Essence styling mousse. I know you guys are like, wait a minute, girl, where is your Aussie? Well, Aussie was 50 cents more, so I'm really trying to be on a budget and save. And I will tell you this, I do like the Herbal Essence. They all kind of like work the same, but when it comes to hairspray, I am awfully, awfully, awfully an Aussie girl. Aussie, Aussie, Aussie. So I'm just going to go ahead and brush some of the hairs up. And I did use a clip just to get my hair back and out of the way, and also to lay the baby hairs down a little bit. I'm going to be using one of my favorite gels of all time, which is the Gorilla Snot Gel. I really do prefer this over the Gatsby, only because the Gatsby gets a little bit flaky. Like, that's the reason why I don't use it as much. Now it's time to style this baby. I'm just going to wet the front of it just a little bit, so that way I can have like the hairs in the front look a little bit more natural and not stiff. And that is the reason why I'm squirting a little bit of water that does contain conditioner in the bottle, along with some of the Herbal Essence mousse. And I'm just going to take my blow dryer and just blow dry and kind of like dry out a little bit of the kind of like hair in the front, so that way it lays a certain direction. This is some really gorgeous hair. It's 150% density. It's super long. That wig is on so tight. Like, do you guys see that? Like, it's on dumb tight, okay? I never used the Gatsby gel to glue down my wigs back then. It was always lace wig glue, like Aquabond or Mastic P or Kryplon or Krylon, whatever you want to call it. I used to always use that because it just gave me like the longest hold. My wig would last probably like 2 weeks at a time, just with the glue and the tape method, which was great, especially because I didn't have to change it up. So I would highly suggest checking out Miss By. I will leave a code down below for you guys, which is April 10. You can save $10 on your order. And like I said, this is the Brazilian pre-plucked loose wave hair in 150% density, 22 inches, and I really do think it looks great. Keep in mind, I will list all the products that I use below for you guys, and if you want to see some more of these full tutorials, I can't promise you anything from back in the days because, hey, that was my old channel. I really don't have those videos anymore. I was just lucky to have this one. So yes, I do have a few old ones, but you know what? I just wanted you guys to see what we used to do back then and let you guys know where it all evolved from. So on that note, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Stay diva and divalicious. Make sure you rate, comment, subscribe. Check the links below for Miss By, and I'll see you guys on a soon to come video. Bye.